ruthless. We got 30 to 100 rounds too. All right.
Hi guys, welcome back to my channel.
Okay, I need to get in the right frame of mind for this episode that I'm about to watch. Today we're going to be watching the finale episode of Euphoria season 2, and I'm very nervous. I'm not even excited, I'm just nervous. Like, my stomach is in knots. I know that somebody is going to die. And I feel like something is going to happen with Rue's, like, drug. Even though they said that episode 5 was, like, her lowest, which was so emotional, by the way. I'm just scared for that. Quick disclaimer before we get into the episode. This is a Cassie hate account. I know that they're not real people and that, you know, you have to have empathy for people. But I never liked Cassie. I didn't even like her in season 1. All of you that are like, oh, they ruined Cassie's character. I'm like, she's always been like that. I mean, did everybody just, like, forget when she was climaxing on the carousel? The multiple cheating, like, times, like, all the time she cheated. Even though her and McKay's relationship was, she's still not a loyal person. And that started in season 1 and has come into full circle in season 2. Like, there's nothing to like about her. She's pretty. She's pretty.
Okay, great gowns, beautiful gowns.
Sydney is beautiful, and Sydney is a great actress too. Another thing, I don't hate Jules. I know a lot of people hate Jules right now. Her cheating was bad, but that's the only bad thing she's done in my eyes. Also, if she knew that Rue got the drugs from, what's her name? I can't remember her name. If she knew that Rue got the drugs from that scary ass lady and she let them flush the drugs down the toilet, even though I think only Elliot knew that, then that's also something that she did wrong. But I don't think she did anything wrong in season 1. Everybody was like mad at her because she left Rue at the train station. I really wasn't. I feel like there was a better way to go about it, but I don't think she is to blame for Rue losing her sobriety. First of all, Rue was never even sober. She came out of rehab. Episode 1 of the whole show, she was doing drugs. Like, Rue and Jules' relationship was very parasitic, and they were just like leaning on each other like a crutch when they both needed therapy. And Jules went through a lot in season 1. Like, I feel like she was still suffering from the whole thing with her mom, where her mom put her in like a concentration camp thing. She's trans.
Hold on, let Candy talk.
Your ass is on tape saying.
And then the whole thing with Cal and then Nate and the catfishing. Like, sis was going through it. She needed to get out of town. And there are a lot of other things I want to talk about, but first let's get into this episode. Okay, and then we'll recap this entire chaotic season at the end. Okay. Alrighty, y'all. I got my ginger ale and my ginger ale refills. That's a tongue twister. At my rice and chicken curry, because food and entertainment go hand in hand. Let's get into this episode. Why is Zendaya crying on the front page? Why is there an ad? There's never an ad. Oh. Why are you shaking your head if you're not gonna say anything? Miss Faye.
Yeah, before you go, bro, I really gotta talk to you about something.
Oh, God.
The fucking cops found Mouse's body.
Sorry.
Sorry yourself. Sorry for yourself. Oh, so she doesn't say something.
Yeah, you know, Lori, the drug dealer that lives in the apartment complex off Kemper. Yeah, you were the one that told me she killed Mouse.
I never said that, bro. We gotta figure out what the fuck we're gonna say.
Oh my god, okay? Oh my god.
This is becoming a fucking issue.
Wait, Ash, no!
Ah! No, 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 he should have done that! Oh my god. Oh my god. I feel like I'm watching Breaking Bad. Oh, but Ash didn't see what her name said, Faye. So he's just like acting on instinct. He doesn't know the police are listening.
Do you ever think about the future?
Yeah, all the time.
Mm-hmm.
Really?
Yeah.
Like, you have a plan?
I don't got like a...
Take my time with writing?
I mean, you really got this shit all figured out, huh?
Yeah, it's kind of crazy, right? I hate guns.
Nobody's ever got shot at and thought to themselves, oh, thank goodness we didn't have a gun to shoot back, you know?
That's a surprise tool that can help us later.
See, if I like a girl, I want to find out what she's about on my own, you know? I don't want to Google the scraps.
Oh my god, I'm gonna die of cuteness.
I wanna peel back the layers.
No, peel back the layers.
Why would you want to waste time?
Oh my god. He's having a panic attack. Bitch, stop. LMAO. If I saw that, I would panic. Bitch, you better wait until the play is over. I need to see what else they have in store.
Oh god.
Oh god, what? All she does is run away. Countdown to her running away. Trip, bitch.
Isn't she brave? She's up here unpacking all of her trauma. I had no idea. I know they hacked the heads off of women in Afghanistan or wherever.
Racist!
I'm not the one putting on a play to humiliate and embarrass you. Oh, really? Then what is this? What act are we in?
Oh my god, I'm speechless. Like,
hi, everybody. Lexi, I'm gonna fucking kill you.
You're not gonna kill anybody.
Because I've actually lived a life.
What life have you lived?
I'm the one who falls in love.
Fall in love with who?
I told you that bitch crazy.
You've never even fucking lived. That's why you're able to stand up here and judge all of us.
If she was actually a good sister, she would know that everything she's saying isn't true.
Then so fucking be it. I can play the fucking villain.
Yeah.
Lexi. Is this the part of the play where I steal Jake from Marta?
No, Cassie, that's not in the play.
It is now. Wait, Hallie steals Marta's boyfriend? I don't know how many times I have to say this, they were not fucking together.
Yeah, not only that, but she was fucking him the entire time Marta was talking about getting back together with him.
I ain't gonna lie, I'm getting cooked.
Why? Because Hallie's a two-faced
period.
Cunt. Why? I'm not a cunt. You're the cunt.
You're the fucking cunt, bitch.
How's she gonna call Maddie a cunt? What did Maddie do that is cunt worthy?
What is this, Venezuela?
Oh my god, not Cats finally having a line.
Oh my god, yes!
Not the carousel scene!
Oh my god, I just left fucking everything!
Why are you fighting yourself?
Oh, this bitch needs to be put down.
Yes! Get her, Maddie! Get her! Oh my god, I've been waiting. She took off her shoes!
No, no, no.
She's running! What did I say? Count down to Cassie running.
Loser!
Get her, yes! Oh my god, yes! Come, Cass, get out of the way! Why is she trying to stop the fight?
Ooh. I ain't trying to get nothing started between y'all, but fuck, was you about to smack that bitch?
I'm so f***ing shook.
A few days earlier, I stopped by Elliot's.
Oh, still think somebody's gonna die. Being a snitch. Rue looks so clean.
Can I tell you something?
No. Oh, okay. Are we gonna talk about the drugs down the toilet? Because that was really messed up of you. You knew that woman was gonna human traffic her. She escaped by the
the hair on her back. I knew they were gonna incorporate him singing into this show. Go, Dominic. As he's singing this song, all I can think about. I hope Cassie has a headache. This is going on for a little long. We don't have time for this. I love his voice, but the song is not relevant to the plot. I mean, it kind of is. I feel like he's trying to tell his story. That was so long. That was like 7 minutes.
I like it. Yeah. I found her.
Oh my god. Poor Lexi.
It could be worse.
It could have been worse. Ro could have been mad. Everybody could have been mad. Only Cassie and Nate were mad.
And me. How many shows in the history of East Highland High has started a riot?
Not a riot. I love Bobby. Are they still fighting in the hallway? Because I want to see that. Why do they always cut away from the good stuff? I mean, not to sound like that person, but I just love the fight.
Lexi, 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 Lexi.
Oh my god, Ro is so cute! Cassie, you hear that?
Mm-hmm.
I'm sorry, I just really hate that bitch.
Hallie, dust yourself off and get back on that
pony. No, I'm still calling her Hallie.
Giddy up.
Giddy up. Oh my god, I want to see more of Lexi and Bobby's relationship in season 3.
A little bit ago, I was talking to a friend about this play.
No offense.
And I asked him, what if I upset people? And he said to me, sometimes people need to get their feelings hurt. So even though he couldn't be here with us tonight, this one's for you.
Oh, now I'm dedicating the play to Seth. I'm gonna explode. Oh my god. He is really bleeding.
Traumatized. Disgusted.
This is an impossible situation. It's gonna get worse though. It's gonna get worse. I can feel it.
Sorry, bro, but we had to make it look like you ain't do this. Come here, bro.
I don't fucking cry.
Just go out there and surrender. It's all on me, bro. You hear me? They gonna come in here. They gonna find me with the knife in my hand.
I'm taking the fall. Don't go to jail, babe. It's the police. It's the police.
Ash, we're not doing this shit, man.
He's just 12. I can't do this. Now, Astro is a writer. He's not gonna let
Ash
first take the. Well, and that's why I think he's gonna die.
Give me the gun.
God, this is so horrible. I have goosebumps.
Come on, bro,
his voice is cracking. Guys! Why is she just standing there? Is that Nate? Now, where are you going? Who are you going to kill? That is a whole nut case, like, he should be in jail right now. He really should. For an uncountable number of offenses. Is he gonna kill himself? I mean, technically, he's supposed to graduate this semester. So they have to find a way to get him off the show. I don't think he's gonna kill himself though. He's a very important part of the plot. Maybe he doesn't go to college. Oh, he's here to kill his dad. Okay. I couldn't get on board with that.
Are you happier? Why don't we go talk about this upstairs? It's a simple question. Yes.
Oh, jeez.
In in some ways.
Is there even a question about happiness to be had in this family? Like, you can't ever attain happiness because...
And just move on and get to be happier.
Like, happiness is not the point here. Let's first get to a healthy mental state. Then we can talk about happiness.
I was 11 years old. I found these videos of my dad fucking hookers in a motel room. You know, for the longest time, I had this recurring nightmare just over and over. And he was fucking me the way that he fucked them.
Oh dear. Not him clutching his pearls! So many things are happening at the same time. I have a low attention span. I can't do this.
There's nothing I regret more.
It's deeper than that though. Maybe if you saw a psychiatrist, the both of you, with Mom and Aaron.
What's your apology? Want revenge.
Ooh.
What does that mean?
Oh, the acting in this show is just 50 out of 10.
What is that? It's everything.
Maybe don't record people without their consent. Obviously, there are more underage people, otherwise, he wouldn't have called the police. Because if not, it's just a sex tape. I think there were more underage people. The fact that he said he didn't know she was a kid, it's just dumb to me. Like, she looks like a kid. You're a 50-year-old man, first of all. Why would you want to have sex with somebody that looks that juvenile? Like, she looks 14 to me. Jules? Yeah. This is a lot. Oh my god. Why did he do that? Why did he do that? You don't know who you're gonna hit. Please don't live on a f***ing cliffhanger. Oh my god, no! I'm gonna cry! Not the card. Oh my god. I don't even know what to say. Like, how do I... Grandma looks kind of different. It's only been 10 years. She looks really different. Oh, not in the head. That's it. That's his life.
Oh, I'm so tired, child. I'm so tired. I'm really tired.
I need.
It felt like a movie.
See, if I was real, I wouldn't like this. I don't know what's going on, but. Lucy is such an angel. The boundaries need to be set, but she's an angel in my heart. Children are so traumatized.
I feel like your whole life you've been forced to take care of everyone.
I watched you die. And all I could think about was how none of it felt real. Let's lift him on three. I wasn't present. I wasn't actually there. I was just watching it.
Cassie looks like she doesn't give a f-. Maybe it's just that I hate her, so I look for every single flaw that she does.
But that's not
But
true.
She really acts like she doesn't care about anybody but herself.
What if...
Oh, God.
The reason it felt like a movie was because you...
I'm surprised I'm not crying because this is such an emotional episode. Maybe it's because the camera is on. I don't think I can cry for the camera. Because anybody that knows me knows that...
Maybe I could still shape.
This is enough to make me rain tears. I cried at Inside Out. Ooh.
All the senior guys are like nice.
Oh, that's the end of the play.
I think your play was the first time I was able to look at my life and not hate myself for everything I've done.
Oh, that makes sense. Like, she made what that was like such a hateful experience for her, like, artistic and just beautiful in a way. Even though it was painful, it was still not in the same light that Rue sees her life, which is just negative all through. Why are they home and she still doesn't know what happened to Fez? And they're mending fences. Oh, her nose is bleeding. Yeah, interesting.
Success!
What's funny?
No, I don't want to know.
They broke up with me before I even went on that stage.
Don't worry. This is just the beginning.
They're just kids. I have to remind myself they're just kids. You guys don't need to be together, Jules. Learn to be by yourself.
Learn to be by yourself and Bill. Get to know yourself. Be by yourself. Rest your front. Rest your brain. Rest your body.
I think Jules wanted to get back together. I think Rue has finally realized that she's not in the space to be in a relationship mentally. That's good enough. You can see that she's forgiven you. You don't need to be... Can't we just be friends?
Jules was my first love. And like, I think I was high for too much of it.
Exactly!
I know it wasn't easy for
her. That's my whole point.
I hope she forgives me. I stayed clean through the rest of the school year. I don't know if this feeling will last forever. But I am trying.
I like this.
Hey Lord, you know.
Oh, that's Lee's voice.
Hey Lord, you know.
Her voice is so pretty. Release music.
Hey Lord.
I'm gonna sit here and listen to this whole song. I'll play it for 10 minutes. I will listen.
Hey Lord.
Okay, so that's the end of the episode. I feel like I already voiced everything I was thinking while the episode was going on. Ashtray is clearly dead at 12 years old. Like, that is the fact that that's the summary of his life. It stabs me in the chest. Like, Ashtray, for the duration of the show, for the part that he was alive, killed three people? Two? He killed Mouse. He killed Custer, and then I don't think that police officer is dead because SWAT usually wears bulletproof vests, but I might need to go back again and watch and see where the bullet hit him. But yeah, that's a high body count for a 12-year-old. I was thinking the other day about just this whole situation, and honestly, Fez and Ashtray's life, just, it kind of reminds me about this thing that Nipsey Hussle was saying before he passed about how crime is more directly related to circumstances than it is to character. Like, poor people are more likely to commit crime because of their circumstances than it being because of their character. They didn't have any parents. Fez and Ashtray, no parents. Fez's grandma is in a coma. Nobody to take care of them. The only way they know how to make money at that age is selling drugs, doing drugs. And the only parent figure that they've ever had in their whole life was a very violent woman. It's like, honestly, it's amazing that Fez even turned out as responsible and empathetic and just the person that he is. But I do feel like it was really reckless of him to shoot through that door knowing Fez was standing right outside there and he could have killed him. I feel like he wanted to take everybody in the house out with him. And that's why he did that. I hope next season we get a Gia episode. I feel so bad for Gia all the time. I just want to like see more into her life and just like her experiences and everything outside of the trauma with her dad and Rue. Cassie is as dumb as a rock. Like, she's so dumb. Like, she really was trying to make them feel bad for her, talking about, oh, Nate broke up with me before I even got up on stage. Are we supposed to feel sorry for you? We don't care, bitch. We don't care about your relationship, your fake ass relationship. Like, that man was literally using you as a cover up for everything that was going on in his life. Like, if there's anybody he has ever loved, it's probably Maddie. And I don't even think he loved her because he was violent towards her. Like, I don't think that's love. I don't think he loves Jules either. I think he's scared that he's, what's it called? I feel like he's attracted to Jules. I don't know. I don't think that's love either. And Cassie, nothing. Yeah, Cassie needs a psychiatrist, like not even therapy. They're probably gonna see like Lexi finding out what happened with Fez in season 3. And what else? I think Cassie and Nate are definitely going to get back together. It's just the way the world goes. Bad things happen. And I hope it doesn't get to the point where he's abusive to her like he was with Maddie. Because if Maddie couldn't get out because of that, Cassie's definitely not going to get out because of that. Like, I feel like she will literally take anything from Nate just so she can say, at least I'm loved.
I'll be weak in the knees. Stand up! Stand up!
Stand up! Bitch, stand up. Fight for yourself. Fight for your dignity.
You have now reached the end of this video. Subscribe for more and like for even higher views for me, because that is important. Okay, see you later.